Now that we've looked at how we mark the stand, if you have any further questions on measurements and management, we encourage you to look at the Upland Hardwood Stand Evaluation publication on the Extension Services website. Continuing on, behind me, you can see the stand that we've just exited, where we've burned and done our mid-story control. It's got the 13,500 oak seedlings per acre, but because there's never been a harvest, you really don't have a whole lot of visibility through that stand. We've increased the amount of light hitting the forest floor, we've increased the amount of oak regeneration on the forest floor, but we're still not done. As we move around, you can see a stand where virtually no management has taken place. We've never burned it, we've never harvested it, and about 5 years ago, we came through and did a mid-story chemical control, but because there was no follow-up, all we succeeded in doing was releasing a lot of non-oak competition along with the targeted oak species, and you really can't tell a whole lot has happened here. That was the foundation for this research project here. In this project, we looked at timing of our mid-story chemical injection. We know that after injecting over here with nothing else done, within 5 years, the regeneration that we released has already come up enough that it's shading in the forest floor and we're no longer getting new oak seedlings. Here, we said, since we know that 4 years, 5 years out, the effect of the chemical treatment goes away, well, I mean, if you have a window of time, there has to be an optimum point of time inside that window for your hack and squirt, for your mid-story control. So that's what we've got here. North and south facing slopes along this ridge. Down at the far end, we hacked and squirted 2 years before harvest. This block that we're looking at right here was done a year before harvest. And this block right here was done the year of harvest. We are measuring this every year, and we're tracking the development of oak seedlings across time as the harvests have gone on. But that's not really why we're here. What we really want to focus on while we're here is the overstory. As you could see when we looked at the other two patches, there really isn't a whole lot of visibility through the stand. And the reason for that is because we've never done the thinning harvest. Here, this was harvested last fall down to our 50 basal area, and not only can you see through the woods, you can see through the woods on the opposite ridge, giving you quarter of a mile, half a mile visibility through one of these stands that's been thinned down to 50 basal area. When you look at it, you can see there's the 30 to 45 foot gap in between all the trunks. It provides a lot of openings. It provides a lot of space. There's a whole lot of light hitting the ground, even on these north facing slopes, giving that oak regeneration the oomph it needs to come on up. Like I said, we're currently measuring the oak regeneration response. We had incredible amounts of regen coming in following our hack and squirts. They got knocked way back down when we drug equipment and logs all over every square inch of that. But this growing season, we've already started to see a rebound of that oak regeneration population, especially in that 3 foot tall to 1 inch around class that we're really interested in, because those are the established ones. Those are the seedlings that are most likely going to come up and be our crop trees in the future.